Now let's talk about an inclined surface which is submerged. So this is how the surface will look like. So you'll have the surface. Let us say the surface is AB, which is at an angle theta to this free surface. Now, if you look at it from this side, you'll see an arbitrary shape. Okay, and these are the centroid and the center of pressures on the surface. Now, the location or the distance of the centroid from the free surface is always h bar, and the location of P from the free surface is always h star. So, this is the location of P and this is the location of the centroid. Let's draw a surface OO, okay, and this is I would say perpendicular to the surface, which is inclined to the free surface. And the distance of P from that section OO is y star. The distance of centroid from that section is y bar. And now we are assuming a strip, and let us say the thickness of this, or the width of this strip is B, and this distance is dy. And this strip is at a distance of y from that axis OO. Okay, so let's find out the pressure on this strip. So the pressure on this strip, as we did for the vertical surface, is the rho into g into h. Okay, where h is the distance of the strip from the free surface, and y is the distance from the line OO. So the pressure force, the small pressure force on this strip would be df, which is this value rho gh, okay, into area. Area is how much? B into dy. So this is B into dy. Alright, so this is the value that we are going to talk about. So this becomes rho g. Rho g into h into dA, that is the small force df. Okay, so if for the entire surface we have to find out, then we will have to integrate, and this will be integral df, integral rho g into h dA, and rho g can come out and you will have A into h bar. So the value of the pressure force is same as that in the vertical surface. Now comes the point where we start finding out h star for it. Okay, for that let's find out the moment of this force about that line. Okay, about that line OO. So that moment is df into y. That's the moment. So if you look at these triangles, if you look at this triangle, h star and y star, so you will have a big triangle like this. Let me make it over here. Okay, so this is h star and this is y star and this is theta. Then you can have a small triangle between h bar and y bar. Then you will have a triangle which is a little small. So this is y bar and this is h bar, this is theta. And then you will have the smallest triangle between h and y, and that would be like this. So this is y and this is h and theta. So we know that h upon y is sine theta, isn't it? So you will get this ratio, h upon y is equal to h upon y, h bar upon y bar is equal to h star upon y star, which is sine theta. Okay, so this is what you get. So from this I can say that for the entire surface the moment would be F into y star, that is the distance of center of pressure from the line OO. Alright, so we know the value for df. The value for df is this. So you will get rho g h into dA into y. Now from this ratio I can get a value for h in terms of y and sin theta. So h over here can be put as y sin theta, and that will give you rho g into y sin theta into dA. Okay, I have put an integral sign in front of it, into y. Okay, so that would be equal to rho g can be taken outside. Inside you'll have y square dA into sin theta. Okay, so if you look at this, only the integral y square dA term, this is the moment of inertia about the line OO. Okay, so I can write it down like this, which is rho g into I naught into sin theta, and that is equal to F into y star. So y star is equal to this upon F, where F is equal to this part. Okay, so let me write that down. We don't want y star, we need h star, and that is where this ratio will come handy. Okay, so your y star is equal to rho g I naught sin theta upon f. The value of f is rho g a into h bar. Okay, so I can strike off rho g and rho g. What is the value of y star? Y star is equal to h star upon sin theta. So that will be equal to h star. That sin theta will go towards the right hand side. You will get I naught sin square theta upon a h bar. Okay. Now what is I naught? We have already seen what is I naught. I naught is equal to, this is equal to I g plus a h bar whole square. Okay, so we can rewrite it as Ig into sin square theta upon Ah bar plus Ah bar square upon Ah bar, and this will also have sin square theta. Alright, so I can just strike off this, and this will also go off. Now a little correction over here, this is not h bar but y bar. So you will have y bar over here. Okay, so no need to cut this off. You will have square over here, and this will also be h bar. Now if you look at that part, y bar square sin square theta, which will be equal to h bar square. Okay, so you will get Ig sin square theta upon ah bar plus h bar square upon h bar. So you can strike off this h bar and h bar square. So the value of h star for this kind of a surface is nothing but Ig into sin square theta upon ah bar plus h bar. So the difference that is there from the vertical surface is only this inclusion of sin square theta, rest everything is same. So I hope you understood this entire analysis on an inclined surface submerged in liquid. Now let's have a look at a simple question on this concept.